activities of people that you recognize, and that this will remind you of God's activity in Faith Baptist.
A celebration of faith. A celebration of faith is a celebration of what God has done in this church through His work in many people's hearts and lives. God does indeed work in mysterious ways, and rarely do we see the full picture when the journey begins. This is certainly the case with our story as we examine how we got here.
Ed Nelson, the executive director of the Rocky Mountain Baptist Conference, had a vision and a passion for planting churches. He spent an afternoon in his car overlooking the Parker area praying, asking God if he would have a church planted here. This was the beginning of the RMBC and Mission Hills planting a church in Parker. It began with Bible studies in various homes in 1971, and in 1972, Faith Baptist Church was incorporated. The people continued to meet in different schools in the area, including Pine Lane Elementary School, where Pastor Thompson was our interim pastor. In 1976, property was purchased on Pine Drive across from Joy Lutheran Church. Permits were granted, and off we went, pouring the foundation for our new building. But not so fast. Because of the existence of Joy Lutheran, the neighbors didn't want another church so close. The local newspaper dubbed the conflict as the Battle on Hallelujah Hill. After careful searching, a technical error was found in our permit. The county, in an unusual move, stopped us from further construction. After a period of pursuing our options and the possibility of getting the permit reissued, it became clear the next step would be a lawsuit. We felt that God was directing us to move on, so we sold the property, which was now a house on the foundation, and the neighbors are happy. We took the proceeds of $55,000 and looked for a new site for our church. Along with looking for property, we hired Pastor Ron McDonnell as our first full-time pastor. This was made possible by financial assistance from the Rocky Mountain Baptist Conference and continued for several years. God led us to Hilltop and Flintwood, already zoned commercial and a location that could minister not only to Parker, but Franktown and Elizabeth. With Sunday attendance now 40 to 45, we started building with a volunteer labor force, working many long hours to build our 40 by 80 country church with a $70,000 loan from the Baptist General Conference. It was a time of hard work and sacrifice, but also fellowship and growth with many potluck Saturday lunches that drew us together. After helping and ministering to us through our first building program, Ron and Betty McDonnell left the ministry at Faith, and we hired a Denver Seminary student, Byron McDonald. A few months later, he became our full-time pastor and served us for the next 9 years. God richly blessed the ministry, and with our attendance at 140, we were quickly outgrowing our little church. We built another 40 by 80 addition in 1983 with $128,000 raised in gifts and pledges for the next 3 years, and once again with much sacrificial volunteer labor. The following years were prosperous and challenging. We saw many people come to know the Lord and many grow spiritually with lots of good memories, but growth has its demands also. We lost some of our people during this time, 3 young men, 2 to cancer, 1 in an accident, and an elderly man who was a mentor to many. They were difficult losses for all of us, but God was faithful and there was a sense of excitement as we saw God work in so many lives. We were at 3 services and desperately needed more space. A temporary bank building was donated to help, and we planned for a new sanctuary because our attendance was nearing 500. We raised $400,000 and borrowed $800,000 more. This building would hopefully meet our needs for years to come. We were well on our way when the call came in the middle of the night, August 11, 1987. The church was burning. All of the old building was destroyed, and some damage to the new construction also.
A huge fire in Parker overnight has left many in the community appreciating where they live and all they have. Suzanne McCarroll is here with more. Suzanne?
Well, Larry, this was a church fire. Fortunately, no one was hurt. Now, members had greatly anticipated the grand opening of their brand new church. Today, they are disappointed but not crushed, and they are very thankful for their firefighters.
The flames just kept spreading. Firefighters continued arriving. It took more than 2 hours to control the blaze. The original church was made of wood. Firefighters say it burned as quickly as paper. The new $1 million wing under construction was spared for the most part. Bricks and steel protected it.
It's just a building, and God can raise up a building. So we're not devastated because the church isn't our life. He is.
Today, church members and one of the pastors survey the damage.
We're a people that really don't need a church. Our Lord just encourages us to continue and press on.
If there's a strong sense of community among the church members, there is an equally strong sense among these firefighters. You see, just about all of them are volunteers.
It was tiring.
More tiring than your regular job.
Yes, very tiring. I'd be sitting at a computer terminal this morning if I hadn't been here.
Derek Potten is missing a day's work from Martin Marietta. Steve White works at Eastman Kodak. But today, they are working here to help. The fire hasn't destroyed the spirit of the congregation. These dedicated firefighters kept the blaze from destroying the entire church.
The cause of that fire is still under investigation.
Strong congregation, where are they going to be meeting over the next several months?
They've already got that lined up. They will be meeting at Ponderosa High School in Parker.
All right. Thanks, Suzanne.
Parker, we're looking forward to the opening of a new addition to their church next month. Now, after a big fire early today, they're lucky to have a church at all. When the fire was reported at about 1:30 a.m., flames were already coming through the roof. It took firemen from five rural departments more than 2 hours to bring it under control. But they couldn't save the old part of the church. The sanctuary, the pews, the organs, and church offices were all destroyed. There is insurance. The firefighters were able to save the $1 million addition to the church. Church director Don Olson told Ray Matoyer they look at it as a test of faith.
Our building is... you know, kind of devastated, but the church, of course, is more than the building, and we're going to keep going on. Services are keep going, and fact is, this Wednesday night, we'll have a prayer meeting right here in the parking lot.
Wednesday prayer meeting, as usual tonight, but outdoors, alongside their burned-out church, heavily damaged by fire yesterday morning. Tonight, they gave thanks that it wasn't any worse. Investigators still don't know what caused it. They haven't ruled out arson. It'll take about 3 months to get it rebuilt, and until it is, Faith Baptist will have Sunday services at Ponderosa High School.
We were completely insured because one of the young men that had cancer volunteered to do a full inventory of the building. Due to his recommendations and the sacrificial giving of his time, we increased our insurance and had all the needed paperwork in order. Praise the Lord. Only God knew what was ahead, and even in disaster, he was in control. All of us were clearly reminded the church is not about buildings or resources or sermon notes, but about God and his people. Our faith is in the living God, and the work wasn't complete. We met at Ponderosa High School for a year before we celebrated the grand opening of the new facility. Because of the fire, we were able to do away with the patchwork of old and new construction. The replacement building was designed that was even more functional than what we had planned. In 1989, Byron and Linda were called to a church in California. Difficult months followed, a time when attendance was down, finances were low, and the mortgage was high. Dr. Jim Means from Denver Seminary served as our interim preacher on Sundays during this time of transition. Again, God provided, and in 1990, he brought Ron and Jody Shevlin to minister to faith for the next 7 years. This was not an easy time to step into faith, but God faithfully worked. Financially, we were able to reduce our debt, lower our payments, and keep going. It was a time of building up the lay people. We evaluated our structure, purpose, and mission statements. We also made significant changes to our constitution during this time. Changes were made that have strengthened the body and how we work together. We continued to make additional payments on our mortgage with the goal of being free of the debt. Ron was asked to come as executive director of the BGC in the Michigan area and left Faith Baptist in June 1997. The work of the ministry at Faith carried on, and God was faithful. The stewardship committee headed up a debt elimination program, and by December 31st, 1997, we were debt-free. The search committee also was hard at work, spending much time in prayer as they sought who God would have as the next Faith Baptist Church pastor. God answered their diligent and prayerful efforts. We are thrilled to have John and Kathy Snyder come and fill the void this last February. So many staff and people have contributed in the ministry over the years at Faith. Hopefully you will see some of them in the pictures to follow.
Each individual church exists for several reasons and meets a variety of personal and community needs. Still, nothing is more important than the basic foundation upon which those churches are built. The foundation of Faith Baptist Church is clearly described in our Constitution. This is what we believe.
We believe that the Bible is the Word of God, fully inspired and without error in the original manuscripts, written under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, and that it has supreme authority in all matter of faith and conduct. To those ends, we strongly support the spread of God's word through the planting of new churches, the support of missionaries, and local community involvement. The purpose of Faith Baptist Church is to honor God by bringing lives into harmony with Him and one another through fellowship, discipleship, and evangelism. We pledge, by the aid of the Holy Spirit, to serve together in a spirit of Christian love, to work together for the advancement of our church, to promote her spirituality and prosperity, to sustain her worship, ordinances, discipline, and doctrine, to contribute regularly to her ministry, and to support in every way the outreach of the gospel to all people.
It is, of course, the people that make up the church. Faith Baptist Church has always been richly blessed with an incredibly diverse, enthusiastic, and talented group of people dedicated to serving Christ with their time, talents, and treasures. Since there is no single way to describe the people of faith, we'll have to show you who we are.
Thank you.
We hope you have enjoyed seeing how we got here, what we believe, and who we are. As you might expect, the story doesn't end here. Until Christ returns, we purpose to continue serving Him. So here is a glimpse of where we are now and where we are going. It has been said, there is no success without sacrifice. If you sacrifice and don't see success, then someone who comes after you will see success because of your sacrifice. If you have enjoyed success without sacrifice, then someone who went before you made the sacrifice. Over the last 25 years, many have made sacrifices for the kingdom of God and the future of Faith Baptist. We benefit from those sacrifices. What sacrifices are you ready to make so that others in the future of faith can see success?
Facility, and I lead this incredible group of people.